We're back, ladies and gents, and it's time for us to sacrifice another faction for our own gain. Such is the way of the ancient world. I'm officially Devin, playing as the Saxons in Total War Attila, if you hadn't worked that out already. And controlling the Franks, my dutiful ally is MrSmartDonkey.
Hello. And my ally, for some death? The Picts. Yeah, I'm ready for the Picts to die to the large onagers and Cairo Ballistra from the enemy. I'm really excited to see what they are actually like.
We've brought our camping chairs, so if you can find a nice hill on the battlefield and then just watch as the Picts charge insanely into the enemy's weird ranks. Cairo Ballistra, yes, and large onagers. Let's see what our dutiful allies can do. The Picts have an army which is pretty much the same as the army I use.
It is, yeah.
So we've actually seen a battle very similar to this very recently, but whatever. Spectate. Let's watch. Watch and learn.
Oh, it said something about... I was just having a read. It said something about due to the weird way this game works and we can't be bothered putting... Oh, never mind. I thought it said something about how the game couldn't be bothered putting a navy in this actual battle, so they would just land the units immediately. But that's not actually the case. I misread it, apparently.
Okay.
I was about to get mental on the game again for being
so close. See, worst game ever. Oh wait.
The problem is that I've had it before in Shogun 2 where the AI sort of like fucks you, where they come in a reinforcement, but or like they're coming as reinforcements, but then they just stand there. It's like, well, you deal with it.
Isn't that what we're planning to do to them?
Well, yes, but it's
not, so
but
you're saying they might do that to us. How unfair!
Yeah, but then we have to. We end up having to fight the battle anyway, which is kind of a bummer. But I guess we'll see how exactly it goes. I'll just put my men back as far as possible and hope that
we'll sit in the corner and hide.
Yep.
That's where the enemy have two reinforcement directions.
So now let's have a look at my heavy spear units, because I don't think we've really had a look at them yet.
Yeah, see if they look any good.
They do look pretty heavy.
They do look more like soldiers than a lot of the other things we've been using.
Yeah, the Germanic warband still looks absolutely horrendous.
Yeah, but they've got axes, so.
And I got my awesome light shock cav, even though I've not really gotten to use them yet. And then we got the onagers.
Maybe you could send just your cav in to help the Picts. Do a couple of raids whilst the Picts are trying to deal with these. What are they, Gallic Romans?
Who knows what we do.
Oh, and they've got crossbowmen in their army, so this will be the first time we see how effective they are.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna have a quick look at them, see what they look like. Some of them are like sitting on the floor for whatever reason.
Yeah, they're looking pretty casual. They're like half hidden. Some of them are like, yeah, I'm gonna hide, and the rest of them are just like, come on, that's just childish.
Those onages are massive. Alright, so where's that other special
well,
unit?
They did say they would be large.
Oh, there's
so
a... Oh, wow.
Satisfied.
So that ballista is like, I think... Yeah, it's like a very light Scorpio. I think that you had those in Rome 1 as well, didn't you? Scorpios or something.
Yeah, you did.
I seem to remember
that.
You
did things like this and they were not particularly useful. We'll see how these ones do.
Anyway, I'm going to put my army a little further back. I'm assuming they can move their onagers if they so wish to do so.
Well, they've got wheels on them.
Yeah.
So they're not static artillery, you'd assume. We'll see. But yes, hopefully the Picts are going to deploy right behind the enemy's deployment zone and then they'll just turn around because they'll be closer. We'll see.
Indeed. We shall see. See, we shall.
I hope we do. Blind. Oh, I guess we could go blind just as this battle starts due to some external circumstances.
That'd be pretty sad.
It would be pretty sad.
Oh, crap, I forgot my...
Oh, someone stood out in front. True heroes.
That's why the weak unit that I didn't want to use in the battle.
Ah, right.
Oh, see, okay, so it said the cav units are coming in as regular men. Because you can see their cav are behind.
So, oh, there's cav are in trouble then if the enemy react to this.
So basically, yeah, it's like, oh, we were too lazy to put the cav... Because the cav, I think in Rome 2 they made it so that the unit comes up without their cavalry. So it's
yeah,
just
they
regular...
just become a land unit on a small boat. Yeah.
Well, it looks like the onagers are turning around for them.
Nice. The enemy have some nice boats, although they are crashing into each other and smashing each other to pieces over there.
Yeah, those are pretty cool boats.
I like their boats. They look good.
I like I've got a flag with the unit on it. Oh god, the enemy is losing ground. Oh, that's good, actually.
That's good news.
The onagers are not sure what to do, it seems. They're all crashing into each other as well.
Very good. Yeah, I guess they were tempted to turn and fire at the cavalry, but then they decided not to.
Looks like they're firing at me, or at least they're moving.
Firing at you?
Yeah.
No, they're just loading. Yeah, this happened in that other battle. Right. They just load while stationary.
They just load. So apparently my axe unit is good against their light melee cap, but weak against their medium melee cap. That seems a bit odd, because it's still the same kind of unit, except that one of them is heavier than the other, but...
Mm. Yeah, I guess it's not a rock, paper, scissors style weakness, it's just a pure stat weakness of some kind.
Wait, they just... No, they didn't fire, they just... they were loaded, and then the thing went up again, I guess because their shift, or their change.
I think, yeah, they're probably just trying to move it.
Yeah.
So it looks like they've put one archer unit facing back. Or maybe they're going to move both to face backwards. It looks like they are going to fire at the enemy's cav.
Yeah.
The enemy's ships are rapidly coming in. So it looks like the picks are going to do the work for us, just as we wanted.
Oh, here we go. First shots are fired.
Oh, they're firing at them. Let's see how the cav react.
Our ally is under attack from the enemy.
Ooh, that's a good first hit right there. Oh, my God, they're getting wrecked. Those are pretty accurate. Oh, they're charging in now.
They're going to charge. Interesting.
They were smart, put the men in loose formation. That's cool.
Yeah, they are loosed up. So it's going well.
Just like your mom. Oh!
Oh! Your words do more damage than those large monitors ever could. Oh, the enemy's cav.
Oh, yeah, they're getting wrecked. That's the enemy. Pretty accurate.
Oh, allies. All right, I get these things confused. What's this? They're actually going to outflank the enemy's army.
They're trying to get to me. Help out, man. What are you doing?
These monitors have a surprisingly fast rate of fire, much faster than the Drome 2 equivalents. Oh, and the enemy's heavy cav are rushing in. Oh, the medium cav. And the picks have light melee cav. Yeah. I think the picks might be about to lose all of their cavalry.
Indeed. Do we care? No, we don't.
Well, that's why we're here. We're literally, like, we've got the camping chairs out and I'm just sitting on a hill at the back. I'm like, oh, good show.
Good
see
show,
what you can
lads.
Do, old chap. It's all the same at the end of the day, isn't it? Life and death.
Good show.
Well, they tried and...
Failed.
Actually, it looks like they're doing a cycle charge. I thought they were retreating, but actually they just left so they can come back in.
Yeah, the enemy's
so
got...
They're using a genuine tactic.
They've got a medium shot cav as well, which I'm sure is...
They're chasing after the medium shot cav. Oh, wait, they've been distracted by the enemy's light melee cav.
Oh, well, here comes the other charge again.
Oh, but yes, they've distracted the enemy and now can surround them. This is some good cavalry tactics from the AI.
Oh, but one of them decided not to do it at all.
Nice, the charge did nothing.
That's how I like to see it.
It's something strange about Rome 2, the charges don't have any impact. Like, they don't kill enemies. And I've never seen them kill enemies. Especially weird when a unit charges into the back of another unit, because it doesn't kill them. The charge just stops, the enemy turns around, and then they commence fighting normally.
The Scorpio is actually fire, but I wasn't really paying attention.
Yeah, and now they're being distracted by enemy's cav. Somewhat killing their crew, although
not
really.
Killed an enemy unit. The Equite Promoti.
Nicely done.
Oh my god, how are these cavalry still going?
And now the picked infantry are starting to get involved. It looks like the picked infantry are just going to charge in without forming up, which could cause
this is
some
like
problems.
This is like us commentating over an online battle or something together.
This is it. Red player is getting royally screwed, but the blue player is screwing himself, so everyone's being screwed.
Meanwhile, the yellow player is being an absolute bitch and sitting on top of a hill back in the distance somewhere.
He knows what he's doing. He's playing the long game. The enemy's onagers are like, I don't know what they're doing. They're trying to form up to face the enemy, but they're all in each other's way, so they're kind of getting stuck.
Those three cavalry units did a lot of work, though. They killed one cavalry unit. He's almost nearly dead. They did well,
especially with light cavalry.
Yeah, they killed 40 men of that ballista unit. They killed a few of the whatever that thing is, crew, the ballista units.
They did a good performance.
Yeah, good shot.
If you hold the space bar down, you can see where the picks are trying to put their men, and it's a very curious decision from the picks.
Like right where the cav is.
They're just moving all of their troops, regardless of class or type, to stand on the exact same spot right next to the enemy.
Although it says a few of their units, I don't get
some of them are gathering up
behind. Right, yes. Okay, so they're going to attack in two waves, I guess.
They're attacking with half, yes. But I don't know what they're trying to do.
And why are their slingers still facing towards me?
Because you're the real threat. They know what's going to happen.
I wonder if I should move my honor just forward enough just so I can start shooting them. I don't know how far away I am.
I guess if the large honors have significantly more range, then they might actually be able to turn and hit you, even though you'll only be able to hit the slingers.
I need to move about... Basically, I'm reaching about half of them, so I need to move the a full distance of range and just enable to be able to
hit them. The enemy are firing flaming shot at the picks.
At the picks?
Oh, baby. Explosives by the looks of it.
Oh, I missed that. Oh, I saw that one there. Oh, and
they're
that
blowing
one.
The hell out of some of their spearmen.
Onagers, holy crap.
They're way too accurate.
Oh my like god, that unit's getting
laser
wrecked.
Laser artillery at that range. They can't even see what they're firing at and they're hitting exactly.
I may have to get involved in this.
I remember that was the case in Rome 2 when it came out, that the siege weapons were just really accurate for some reason.
I might get my cav involved just to see if I can get a bunch of kills.
You can see the crew of the Chiro Ballista has actually abandoned it and just formed a line.
Yeah, I saw that.
They're not actually using their weapon. I guess they're not able, the AI isn't able to put them back on once they've left.
I know, I did see them before, it's at 0 out of 4, and then they went up on it again, and then they left it again, I don't know. The Onagers are in a really weird formation as well, yeah.
Yeah, they're screwing themselves over, but I think they're firing over the top of each other, so it's okay.
I'm gonna get my cav in here. See if I can help out a little bit.
Right, let's see what the picks do. Oh, they're falling back.
I feel like it's very tough in this game to get experience for your troops. It takes so long.
Yeah, you have to get a lot of kills, and then they lose it if they regenerate, so...
Yeah.
You never really get anywhere. So all the pick troops are exhausted.
Oh yeah, that
they're ballista... gonna go into the fight. Enemy is using a wedge cavalry charge against their medium axes.
Very smart target.
They didn't get very far in, actually. No. And the medium axes might just screw them over.
And the whole point of a wedge formation is to get as far penetration-wise as possible.
Yeah, they got like 2 men in. Right, now the real fight begins.
Yes.
The enemy's Nordic. Oh, they're using Nordic Band. They're screwed. Nordic Band. They're somehow combat even with the enemy's very heavy spears. That must be a miscalculation by this tooltip. There's no way that's the case. Another squad, Nordic Band. It's already lost 100 men, but it's still fighting on.
Nordic Band may as well be naked. It just doesn't have any armor.
It's pretty close. They've killed one enemy and they've lost over 100 and now they've routed. Oh, so God. Another great performance from the Nordic Band. I guess the whole time the Onagers are still really whomping on the enemy. That laser guided us. Oh my god. That is so unfair. That's hilarious.
I'm about to attack this man. Although it looks like he's got one of the swordsmen. His general might be coming for me. Nope, he's turning around again.
No, they're fine. So the enemy's axemen are taking out the crew of the ballista, so that's them taken care of. Their Nordic Band are really struggling against the enemy's legionaries.
Oh god, yeah,
Comet Atensis, they're not doing very well.
Still has a Nordic Levy unit all the way at the back for some reason.
I think they landed some of their units like really far down the coast just for fun.
Are about to charge into their slingers engages. Now, and I'm getting their honored crews as well.
I are attacking. Yes. That's very kind of you.
Just a cav, though. I'm not going to do anything else.
Okay, so the shock cavalry. Let's see how shocking they are. They penetrated 0 men into the enemy's formation, so they're obviously not that shocking. And they're now just stabbing their slingers to death. Yeah, their slingers are totally screwed. That's the enemy's ballista crew. Oh, it's been messy in here. Looks like the same thing's happening to them. They're going down very quickly.
Just like your mom.
The enemy's got their skirmishers in combat with the enemy's heavy swordsmen. Not the best of choices.
This is really good. The picks are going to lose a lot of men here.
Yeah, so if the picks had a plan, we've cunningly stopped them from succeeding with this little tactic. Their losses must be huge. Although, because they had so many low-quality troops, like losing all the Nordic Band is a lot like losing nothing.
Essentially, yeah.
God, right, the enemy's crossbowmen are now in melee. That can't be going well for them.
I'm not losing anyone from the cav, but I'm not doing any damage either. Although one of the units actually got
The crossbowmen are surviving quite well. It's just shot cavalry. Oh, they're slingers.
Oh, here we go.
Coming in for another round with the cav.
Yay, we've done it.
Totally roasted.
Victory.
Enemy general's dead.
Oh, good stuff.
We did it, guys. It was all us.
Yeah, cavalry.
Do you think we're good players now? Did you see how we skillfully won that battle without losing any troops?
Not a single man was lost. Not a single one.
Very good.
Good show.
This is the sort of tactics that take you ahead in pre-Dark Ages Europe.
Indeed. I wonder if I should kill more of their units. You didn't really do it.
Gets me XP.
I might want to kill like a few more just to make sure they don't survive this battle. I probably could reach them afterwards though. Triple speed it for a few seconds.
I think they're probably got their army will just get deleted after this. They've lost too much.
Possibly, yeah.
They've got one cavalryman he's going to escape.
Oh, well, I got another experience chevron right there, so that was worth it.
Very good.
Actually, I did get a fair few kills with the cavalry, by the way. Okay, let's not exit the desktop.
Close. Achievement
a decisive battle. I didn't lose a single man. It should have been heroic plus two. Or something.
That's it. Yeah. Losses, zero. Check it, ladies and gents. Zero losses. The enemy losing over 1,000 troops. How did we do it? Don't ask the Picts. The Picts know how we did it, but they're not telling anyone.
I'm going to edit off the Picts here as well. Just me, zero losses.
Yeah, you can shop that out. We can do that. That'll be fine. Very easy.
Crazy.
Yeah. We're so good at this game.
Hell of a battle, yeah. I don't know how we haven't won this campaign yet, to be honest.
Even the Saxons didn't lose any troops in that battle. That's how good we are.
Oh, God.
Well, it looks like every rebel army is going down. They're one unit of the legionary cohort, with over 200 of the Picts. Not that the Picts are involved in this battle.
I can even take on warriors and replenish 1% of the nothing that we lost. It seems fair.
Well, you could do it. You do have one unit in your army. Isn't that full strength?
Yeah.
So you put them in there.
Is there nothing else?
Oh, they survived?
No
what
way.
Is that? One unit?
There must be like three men in that squad.
And they're in like in someone else's territory, so I can't do anything about it either. Okay, screw them. They can survive. Actually, I did the getting money, but the thing is, I noticed that when you win battles, you get so much integrity from that, so that it's worth getting the money, because you lose some integrity, but you gain it back the next turn anyway.
Yeah, because you got plus 10 for battle one,
exactly.
Minus 6 for not taking captives. So
yeah,
and you're already at 100% integrity anyway,
exactly,
so you might as well just do it.
So
take the money.
It's definitely pretty good. Okay, I want to get that, and let's see. I want to get some battle movement speed. Sounds good. Right, so first of all, I need to make Hermagar. My new one.
Oh my god.
He needs to. Okay, he has got 440. Yeah, he's going to make Belgica pretty happy. That's good. And Frisia, I'm not going to put a guy in there since I just want to lose it at this point.
It's not going to lose. You're just going to keep seeing your population migrate elsewhere over and over again.
Alright, so Augusta Javorum is at minus 9. God, when is that ever going to become happy?
This is actually, it's like the best public order it's had in a while. It's now going to not rebel for like another 4 turns. It's going to be great.
And the new guy that's coming in there is going to make it a little happier as well.
Very good.
So yeah, the rebellion is going to happen. I can reach it wherever it happens, except if it takes the town right away, that's going to be a bummer.
Yeah, so I have to be lucky.
I could even put the army from Augusta Trevorum into Argon Tutorum. Taratum, even so that I make sure they don't take that, but if they then take Octoduron, that's kind of a bummer as well.
Well, I'm gonna have to gamble.
I don't like this. I'm gonna get rid of that. I'm gonna get rid of this, I think. Just ban that and that. Although the fields are giving me money or food, but I've got enough. Food. It's food. Okay. Got a little bit of money left, but I don't think I'm gonna spend it on anything. Right, I wanna see. What can I recruit for units here? Oh, never mind.
Nothing.
Oh no, wait.
I'm confused.
No, okay, right, I'm just having a look at units. So yeah, I can't recruit the Germanic Warband here, so I don't know how I recruit them actually. I was having a looking at, like, I can make Germanic Mounted Warband, which is... Oh, that's a very light melee cav, actually. I thought they were a javelin, jav cav.
Yeah, but jav cav.
They're not. They're just a melee cav, so I might make some of them. I mean, I much prefer Lancer Shock cav, but I don't know, these don't really seem that amazing, but I don't think the regular cav is going to be that amazing either. I just remember when you got charged in one of the like in the first episode with a cav unit on your Nordic war or Nordic band, they got absolutely wrecked. They lost like 80 men in a single charge. That's what I want to see.
That was like it was the Roman scout cavalry charging.
Yeah, it was the Equites
scout.
Unit
with shields and spears, but still just completely destroyed them.
Yeah, that's what I want to see. That's what I've been hoping for. But like you saw me charge just their skirmisher unit didn't do anything.
Yeah, so it kind of just stopped. Yeah, but, never mind.
Anyway, I think I'll make another Germanic... Actually, no, I'll make another Frankish Lancer here. Come, four of those. Okay, so at least I can make that. I can make Germanic Warband in Fasoncio. So if I wanted to have any more of those, I can make them here.
Very good.
Although I think the Freemen are better than them, but I can't be bothered comparing every single stat right now. I also have four archers I might want to actually get rid of and make skirmishers, but right now I can't really do that, because if I do that, then the rebellion's going to be even more annoying.
Yep.
Okay, non-aggression pact, religious change, development, trade gain fearful for Emelrich. Really?
Sounds handy.
Is that him? Yeah, that's him. Why? Why did he gain that? This man runs from a battle before it's strictly necessary or lost. I neither lost nor did I run. I didn't engage in the battle, but that's something else. Well, I guess he lost one zeal. And now he's only got six. And he had seven, which is pretty cool. And we got Owen, right the rank, but I already did that too. Okay, cool. So, I think that's that. Let's end the turn. Oh wait, okay. I have an issue to do in Belgica, of course. Oh right, yeah, more happiness. Look at that. Plus four from... It's only 54% freaking paganism. Why does it take so damn long?
Yeah, it goes up really slowly. It's like zero... Well, I was just looking at it for Britain. It's going up by 0.7% per turn.
Yeah, I'll take the other one that increases Germanic paganism then. You still need to assign a governor. I don't really want to assign a governor now, because it doesn't help me here. I've only got bad people.
Yes, can only assign useless people who will ruin everything.
Yeah.
Term of office, AMR has completed his term of office as a companion. Which reminds me, I need to chuck everyone into terms of office. So, Horsa in Britannia Inferior, the governor, you are now a companion. I think, yes, you are. AMR, oh, you don't have the influence to do anything, never mind. Edmund, you're general in Britannia Inferior, you can be a companion. Uses all of your influence. Wigbjort, the governor of Frisia. You can be a companion. Merry Christmas. And Hengist is a judge, but I can promote him to be tribal chief. You are now the tribal chief. Enjoy it. So that's that sorted out. Let's check out my new daughter that I stole from the Geats. Let's see. Do you want influence? It looks good. So she'll be moving to sunny Britannia to join my son as the governor there.
Oh, can you see the general in the Picts army, by the way? The army
the
that
Picts
helped
army.
Before. He's got a pretty cool picture.
Hello, oh, yeah. Like his... He's looking right at you, staring into your soul. Because he knows what
you
did to his men.
Me?
Oh, God. I'm going to be haunted by Andecombogius.
Yep.
Insert name here.
Sounds right.
Something like that. Right. So I've now got a bit of cash. I still can't convert anything. I need to build a chieftain's hold in Britannia, which give me a bit more public order, and unlock the recruitment of Hearthguard, which are a medium sword unit, which may actually be useful.
The rebellion happened in Octoduron, by the way, so it's probably going to get taken again.
Ah, very good. Always hated Octoduron. Right, actually, I'll build the religious converting building here. Gives me plus one sanitation. Oh, but it loses a public order bonus if I convert it to that. So with religious buildings, you have the choice of a chain that gives you public order but not much religious conversion, or one that gives you no public order bonuses but religious conversion. I kind of need both, because the reason I need religious conversion is because of the public order problem. So that's quite a not a particularly useful decision to have to make.
That's what I've got with the edict now, is that I either get happiness from the or public order from the religion, or I get more religion, which will then increase public orders.
Yeah, it's the same sort of thing.
Yeah.
So I kind of want to go to neither, because I need to save my money to build that chieftain's hold, which will give me public order. Now let's just check the situation in Rujon. It's still getting pretty angry. I can build a chieftain's hold there, or chieftain's hall there, which will give it plus five public order, which will stabilize it.
Chieftain's
hall. I need 20 food in order to do that. So let's just check the local food situation. It's on 25, so I can do that. Let's do it. Screw money. Right, so that's all from me, I think. That's all I can really do. I guess my Serpent Strokers could go and just raid someone, but they're not at full strength, and I do need them to garrison the capital. So many garrison needs. I think that's all I'll do for now.
All right.
What was the other thing I was going to do? Oh, I was going to check to see if anyone could trade with. That's the other thing I was thinking that I haven't done for ages. See if I can get some more cash. Burgundians are tempted. They accepted the offer. Very good.
Nice.
Thanks, mates. What do you got? The Caledonians, the guys to my north. Probably going to be at war with them at some point, but let's see if they want to trade. Moderate chance. Rejected. Okay, trade. I'll pay you a little bit. What's the value of the trade? 200. Okay, I'll pay you 300 for the deal. So I'll make a profit soon enough. Rejected. Okay, I'll screw you guys. What else we got? Illyrians. Ah, you tried to trade with them, didn't you? Moderate for me. Rejected. Oh, you son of a bitch.
Oh, I got 900 from them for trade.
I didn't like me. So the Morians, the crazy African faction, they're moderate. Rejected. Why is everyone rejecting my choice? What's wrong with it? Okay. Rugians. Moderate. Yes. It's two deals acquired. Thurungians, the guys I'm supposed to be at war with. Do you want a non-aggression pact? No. Do you want trade? Didn't think so. Okay. Never mind. I'll come back and see you guys later. That's the end of that.
See you later.
Wigbjord has an unassigned skill. Who is he? Is he a commander? Oh, God, I don't know. I can't remember who he is. Oh, I think he's the governor of my capital province. Let's give him this minus 20% construction cost. And that's going to give him sacking income. That's not really useful. Personal influence. He's not in my faction, so that's probably a bad idea. I'll give him a household apparel. No, that's not. Oh, that is useful. Plus one authority. That's going to help you govern. Yes, it is.
Oh, I just realized when I lose Frisia, I'm going to lose about half my income.
Did you really need that income? What you want to do is allow me to take that income, because I'm going to spend it much more wisely.
Why does it give me so much money from that one shitty town? It's like,
I think it's because your capital province, regardless of what it is, gives you a bonus.
So like when it changes to income. A different capital, I'll get more money.
So yeah, another province will just randomly get plus 1,000 to its wealth.
Okay, I hope so.
What are the Geats up to? They didn't quite finish off the Danes, but they've had enough. So once again, they're heading back home.
Yeah.
Did I accept that defensive alliance? Oh, no, I didn't get the defensive alliance.
Yeah, because they offered you something else.
I stole their daughter instead and got distracted by that whole deal. Never mind. The Jutes are still on a war path. I wonder where they think they're going. Maybe they really are just like going to go and settle in Greece or something like
that. Maybe they're like, well, we want to be Huns now.
Screw our Scandinavian roots. I'm going to go and be a Mediterranean culture. We'll fit right in.
Oh, God.
All right, Western Romans, what are you doing? I always see the Western Roman Empire move troops into Iberia, like every turn. Something must be going on there. Notice the Caledonians haven't actually expanded out of their conquest at Rota Majus. I thought they were going to go on a warpath and to try and conquer all of Gaul and take all the Roman provinces.
Are these guys going to take care of my rebels?
What's this? They are. Well, that's quite kind of them.
Are they going to follow them, though? Probably not. But
no. No, they just felt like sneaking in and attacking them.
I think they can still reach Octodurum.
We'll see, yeah.
But at least they tried. And now I'm going to have, like... Yeah, foreign trespasser, and my clan will dislike them, even though I don't care.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, they just try to help.
I can ally with them.
Oh, wait, are they, is that the Swabians?
Yeah.
Who the hell is this? Oh, that one random unit. Oh, crap.
I can't see what's happening, it's better be good. Oh, that guy, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, they didn't come to attack, at least.
Sent a squad of Nordic band. Oh, he's suffering attrition. He must already only have about 3 men. His integrity is at maximum, though. How is that even possible? He lost that massive battle, and he has 100 integrity with his 4 surviving soldiers. They must be very loyal.
Right, I'll go out and attack them, I guess.
Well, he didn't lose Octodurum, and the rebel army's now suffering attrition, though they're still recruiting.
Oh, crap, I'm taking attrition from running here. Oh, well.
Oh, yeah. He probably lost more men than the enemy had. He's just moving to fight them.
Yeah. I didn't lose much this time. Let's get some more money, lose 2 integrity. Get moving! Okay, can I move back without losing my entire army?
Say goodbye to all your troops on the way.
Say goodbye. Oh, 0 happiness, or 0, like,
we're not going down. You've stabilized. Perfect. Nice.
All right, sadly, I can't really...
be a turning point.
I can't really go out and chase off those rebels that are over there.
I think leave them and take the public order bonus. They're going to have attrition.
I can't even reach them, so... But do I go sit in Octodurum instead?
I would say You probably should, because they can't take this onto you anyway.
Yeah, but they're...
It's the safe option, but then your army will lose all its men on the way.
True. Although, I was going to say, maybe they can reach Argent Doratum, but I can't even reach them in one turn from here, so I don't think they can.
Yeah, I think the winter must really limit movement range, so they probably can't.
All right, let's take the attrition. Oh, we didn't actually take any attrition. That makes sense.
Okay, I guess these roads must be proper working roads.
Proper big roads.
As they always say, here in this little island part of Europe.
All right, I have a chieftain's hut. No, that's a town center. What's a chieftain's hut then? Is that this one? That's an iron smelter. God, what are all these buildings?
You're an iron smelter.
So a chieftain's hut. What is that? Okay, that goes into a chieftain's hall. Okay, that does give me quite a few units
down there.
Yeah, I definitely want to get that. Or otherwise, no, we already have a farmstead. I do want a second farmstead. Guess I'll make a second farmstead here. Make a chieftain's hall here. All right, and now I just need to convert the main buildings, which is going to take a little while before I can afford to do that. But it's pretty good. I also should probably get a third army at some point, but for now I can't really afford to do that, because especially if I want to lose Frisia, which will happen next turn, or at least the rebellion. Actually, no, not next turn. Turn after is going to happen the rebellion. So yeah,
to build some wealth first, build some stability in our provinces.
Yeah. Well. I have a well there, so.
Oh, I see. Well, that explains that.
Wondering if I should get rid of the well, although it does give me sanitation, which I guess is good.
I always hated that well.
And it gives us growth. Yeah, sure, I'll upgrade that too. Why not? Let's do it.
He's insane. Somebody stop him.
Can I make any agents yet? Nope, not a single one. I need to figure out what buildings I need for now.
Yeah, we'll never know. I haven't seen like a tool that mentioned that it allows agents, so I don't know what it is.
Hold on, you need a market stalls, a warrior shrine, and chieftain's hold.
Yeah, I'm soon to have a chieftain's hold.
There's the chieftain. I want the chieftain's hold.
Oh yes,
as well.
Enables agent recruitment champions. There you go. It is in the tooltips and stuff.
Where is that? Market stalls and warriors
market
hold.
Stalls in the same chain as the chieftain's hold, or some one of the branches. I might be lying. No, I am lying. Oh yes, it's at the start. So you build a town center in a city, like a walled city, and then you can build market stall, which unlocks spy.
Wait, is it like the main upgrade?
It's the second upgrade of town. Oh, sorry, there's a building called town center which you can build in cities.
Oh, I see. Right, okay.
I think in Not Cities it's called something else, but it's not as good. Yes, Chieftain's House is the Not City equivalent, but that can't be upgraded into a market.
I see.
City. He sees it. Sees it with his clouded British eyes. Clouded by years of poverty.
Oh, wow. The second tier upgrade for the military tree is a plus 8% campaign movement range. That's not bad.
Yeah, pretty decent.
And capacity replenishment, that's all pretty meh. 50% wealth from subsistence even. What does that even mean, subsistence? What is that?
It's like subsistence farming, where you farm precisely the amount required to not die and no more. So it's basically your people attempting not to die, you're taxing them for it and making wealth of it. So like going
sense.
Around someone's vegetable patch in their garden and saying, that's subsistence farming, you owe me one of those, steal a cabbage. That's exactly what it is.
All right, my general Emelric is becoming worse and worse. He just gained a trait arrogant. I am awesome. No, really, you don't understand. And he loses 2 influence per influence earning situation, and he loses 1 loyalty.
Perfect.
These sons of mine are getting worse and worse, and he's my son and heir as well.
You can kill them. Well. It's that little intrigue thing, so you can just have them knocked off and try and adopt someone else.
Yeah. Everyone's fucking terrible now, except for my main guy, the main man, Frank.
Have everyone killed except him. There's only going to be 1 officer in the whole of your domain. he's going to be the greatest man of all time, but hopefully he won't get arrogant about it.
Food and... Oh, that's him, right. Okay, right. I'm Dunsey's... I'm still assigned a provincial governor. Get the fuck out of here again.
yeah. Right, now let's see if it'll let me go into my turn. It will. A political obstruction. What's this? Oh, because Horse is trying to be a companion. Gimpy Goose doesn't want him to be, for some reason.
Hey, there's an enemy spy there.
Enemy spy?
Caledonian spy. Or I don't know what he is. He's a scout, yeah.
Oh god, my guy's trying to stop everyone getting into office. I'm just doing the things that make the guy lose his influence, because they're all not in my family, so I don't care. Yep, keep going. Right. There we go. Where was this spy?
In your,
oh yeah, Britain, I see him. Yeah, cheeky. So they have that building, obviously. Which means I can take it, because I plan on capturing their province.
Yeah, Borovcum.
Because that's the capital of mine.
Borovcum looks pretty undefended.
It is. The thing is, I don't want to go to war with them, because they have these stacks just around the place. Just like sailing in the sea.
Oh, is that the... Oh, no, the Picts get messy. Yeah, yeah.
The Picts have only one settlement, and that's the ones who are near you. The Caledonians are the ones who have Rota Majus.
Oh, yeah, the Caledonians have sitting the around there. Next, or south of the Duro Curatorum. That's the Caledonians as well.
Do they?
Yeah, to the southwest of Duro Curatorum.
The Rota Majus, is what you mean?
What? Yeah, Rota Majus, yeah. Rotten Tomatoes.
It's pretty close. Right, Rujon's still deteriorating public order. I've been 3 turns, they'll be okay. Although that's okay with... Whoops, shit. I accidentally moved my main force out. Okay, they just took a bunch of attrition. Back in you go and re-recruit those men. Good show. Bit of military drill.
It's like training.
I don't have the money to do what I was going to do, so... That's it from me. That went pretty well. That was a good turn. I lost a few hundred men marching out into the snow and marching back.
Which army was it that you moved out?
My main force in Rujon. I accidentally left and went back in, and they lost 20% of their army. It was great.
In Rujon. Oh, wait. So, you still...
East of my thing.
I completely forgot you have an army over there.
Random province that I have. My main force is just locking it down because they really hate me, despite having the same religion.
Oh, my God. Are you going to take any more of that province at some point?
Well, I don't know. The Thuringians, who I'm at war with, I might have to attack. Actually, that province is just east on the coast.
If you want to take Gothis Kanza, they've got fucking 2 stacks, and it's a major town, and they've got a navy there as well. That's what I mean.
It's not going to happen.
How the hell is anyone ever going to take that?
I'm just seeing if any of these guys who rejected trade when they wanted it now.
Because I think someone commented at some point, and I think it makes sense. If you instead go for... The top province, it makes more sense, especially now that it's a desolate. I don't want it anymore. But it makes more sense, especially if you're gonna have the Netherlands as well, or like the province you've already got partially. You may as well go for that too at some point.
Might as well make some level of sense.
And then you can deal with the 4-5 stack geats right there.
Who is this Edmund guy? He's losing a lot of integrity. He's going to mutiny in 5 turns. Who is this guy? Oh, the guy garrisoning Camaldenum. His integrity is dropping rapidly because he has no captives. He's using -9, and I don't know what that means or if I can do anything about it.
You have to fight some battles, I guess.
So he's going to betray me, but I mean, my other army nearby is better, so if he does, I guess that's okay. But I can give him a skill, which may or may not help. I give him extra authority. That might improve his integrity. It might not. And I'll give him some zeal. Does that do anything? Oh, it does, actually. It slightly lessens the rate. There's now 6 turns until mutiny instead of 5. So there you go. That did something.
Not bad.
Let's keep going, then.
Let's
maybe I should
do
some political stuff on him. Make him more loyal. Actually, no, because it's not him. It's his men that are going to mutiny, so he will have to fight his own men. So I guess that's okay.
Are you sure about that?
I'm not sure.
Are you willing to put your life on that?
I'm completely unwilling, but I feel safe in the knowledge that we've crushed enough British rebellions, so even if another one happens, even if it's our own troops, we can still find a way to crush it.
Crush.
I just love crushing British people. That's what I told the judge. He seemed on board with it.
Oh, you're killing me here.
You're killing me, man!
Well, it wouldn't be the first time.
That one Western Roman ship, how long has it been sailing back and forth between that? Because we always zoom over to it.
They're obviously having a Geat-style problem where they don't know what they're doing.
Apparently,
wow,
yeah.
Did you see that? There's a big Roman army near you.
Oh, God, why?
In Lundunum, there's a almost full stack of Roman troops.
Yeah. Don't say that.
There is. There's also two rebel armies
Can you still see it now?
I can see it now, yeah.
Then I should be able to see it in a minute as well.
Show you. Oh, the Varinians, the guys I stole this province from, are coming back. The tree breakers with no units and the suffering attrition.
Oh, it's Legio XXX again. This is Legio XXX Ulpia Victis. Did they survive? I don't remember.
I think that they were going to attack us and then they buggered off.
Maybe,
just around
yeah.
the time you started capturing your Belgica. So I guess they've done whatever they were doing, which was probably losing to the Swabi, and now they're back for revenge.
Okay, I can see 5 units of it. It's got some mercenary Germanic warband, mercenary Germanic hunters. Yeah, what I can see isn't that impressive, but that doesn't say...
Okay. Thing is, there's also 12 units worth of rebel Roman troops under the Gaulish banner.
Oh, what the... Who are those other rebels, though? They're not mine.
I think Lundunum.
Oh, yeah, that was also rebelling. The problem is they're sort of in the way. Actually, I can't reach the other army anyway, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, so the one at the bottom is Lundunum. One at the top is you. And they're both recruiting.
At least I'm getting
happy. There's going to be a lot of enemies in this area.
Yeah, because if those two armies attack at the same time, although the Legio 3, or sorry, F30 XXX, is somewhat depleted on a few units as well. So hopefully all of them are somewhat depleted.
Well, with any luck, the Legio will attack the rebels from Lugdunum, since they belong to them, like they're their rebels.
Oh, right, yeah.
So maybe they might just be here to fight them, and then they'll bugger off again.
It's just, yeah, because they're Gallic Rebels. There's all those images, they, I don't know, they look pretty similar, the red, like, line around them.
Yeah, they have very similar icons, kind of hard to distinguish.
Hmm. Quite so.
Yeah, creative assembly.
Get your shit in the
game. Do you realize these circular icons, they're destroying us? What was wrong with flags? And really big flags as well. Everything's smaller in Attila. Like the characters on the map are smaller and all the icons are smaller than they were in Rome too. Just make it extra hard to know what's going on.
Yes, extra hard.
And I like it extra hard. My doctor will tell you that.
Okay. I'm just wondering if I should make a third army, but as I said, I'm about to get another rebellion. So let me see if it says anything about... Because you said... Your capital gets more money. Maybe it says something about its income.
Yeah, I don't know if it tells you about it, because I think it's an invisible bonus.
Yeah, I think it's invisible.
You'll see that AI has it as well. They have random towns which are just really wealthy, and that's probably their capital.
Okay.
Yeah, like I'm making 1,400 from Tullifordum.
Yeah, it makes more sense, because that's money. Like an actual like big town.
Oh, the money actually might be about accurate. So maybe there isn't a bonus. It looks like it is, actually. Because I got 750 from a building I have there, which is why it's so high, and 400 from the city itself, and then some from farming. Oh, and you've got the bone carver as well. So actually, yeah, maybe you are actually making that money, and you would really massively lose out if you lost it.
Don't say that.
And I would massively gain. I mean, since it's a co-op, your loss, my gain. That's a net neutral, so it's fine. It's just more fine for me than it is for you.
Just a little bit more fine.
But let's not think too much about the details. I need that province, man. You're in my territory. I have the capital of this region. You're just a pesky intruder.
It's
hogging
true.
The trade port, which I need. I have to get this rubbish trade port over in Rujon, which is probably going to get rebelled or taken back by all these other guys soon enough. So I need to abandon that province so I can come and take Flivum instead, which is going to be much more useful. Actually, Rujon is making 1337 in wealth, the most elite amount you can possibly make.
Damn. Okay, right. I think I am going to make a third force. I need to know, what can I recruit here now? Okay, it looks like I can recruit Germanic Mountain Brigands here now.
They sound good.
And the Germanic Warband and the Germanic Spearman. I just can't recruit the Frankish skirmishers, which is one that I want.
You're just jealous because you don't have any Nordic band. I can now recruit Nordic sponges. They cost one to recruit and have zero upkeep. They're just a pile on the battlefield that stops the enemy temporarily.
Oh god, that Fodimer, I want to make him another... I want to make him a general, but he's got only one authority, which means he loses 14 morale. Oh, it's only for the commander's unit. He loses 14 morale. I guess I don't really care about that.
Okay, so the men who are close to him and realize that he actually has like a really high-pitched, quiet voice. He doesn't sound like a real commander.
Yeah, I'll take that. Fodimer, raise an army. Didn't particularly like the choosing a unit in Rome 2 for your general, but I wish there was at least like, because in that it was kind of weird how you could basically choose a unit that you'd be able to recruit later on anyway, so you'd have a general unit that's the same as a regular unit later on.
Yeah,
but I would have liked it if you had at least an option between an elite infantry and an elite cavalry unit or something like that. But yeah, then an elite cavalry unit that no one else, that you can't recruit normally, like that would be cool. But sadly, that's not the case.
I've noticed that my main army under Hengist in Britain is also suffering -9 integrity due to no captives. So I think doing that sale of thing seems to have a big permanent effect if you sell prisoners for money. Because the two armies that have done it have this permanent debuff.
Oh, is it permanent?
I wonder if it's supposed to be permanent, but...
I don't think... No.
It seems like a very extreme...
Because my guy doesn't have it anymore.
Maybe it's just because I haven't fought a battle recently. But I mean, they have fought battle a few turns ago, and which haven't.
Is it the no captives one?
Yeah.
Because I've got -8 on that.
The Serpent Stroker says -2 for no captives, and my main force under the faction leader doesn't. It has -5 due to attrition, but that's okay. That'll probably go away soon.
Yeah, I do hope that goes away, because if it's going to be -8 for that other army for the rest of time, that could be pretty problematic.
Yeah, you'd have to just win a battle every turn, basically,
yeah,
to keep it up. And I already struggled to keep it up.
Is that perhaps what she said?
I think I've heard her saying it one or two times. I'm surprised that she has won, though. Let alone that she struggles to keep it up.
All right, your go.
My go?
Go your.
Fantastic. Well, I've got 5,000 gold, so I can build that thing... whatever it was.
Again.
Oh, I failed my mission to be at war with the Thuringians. Oh, too bad. Oh, that's because they've been destroyed. That's why faction destroyed. My Imperium just went up. Don't know why.
Yeah,
construct
a
building from industry chain in the next 4 turns. I'm probably not going to do that. I am going to build this. Chieftain's Hold. I lose 50 food, and I've got 52, so we can just about sort that out. Actually, I lose 30 because the one I already have is on -20, so that's okay. Gives me a tad of wealth and +3 public order. But most importantly, I can recruit a unit with it. So it's a nice long-term investment there. So that's the money gone. What else can I do? Anything to repair or something? No, not really. So let's have a look at the old technology. I've just done militarized society, reducing my upkeep, which is quite useful. Is there anything else I can do? Reduce recruitment cost. I kind of need reduced upkeep, so all these giant garrisons I have, just keeping public order wouldn't be so costly. I don't see any others I can get for that.
Damn it. There's a civil war again instead of just a regular...
Not again.
So you're never going to be able to get that town, I'm guessing.
Yeah, probably not.
I'm just going to keep letting it rebel until something happens.
Until it rebels properly. What do they think they're doing? Who is it this time? Is it the same faction? Yeah, I think it is.
Yeah, it's the Frankish
Settlers. Birds of Prey this time. Ermin Guild.
Well,
yeah. Well, it's good. I need to defeat him so the Serpent Strokers can get some captives and stop being so angry with the lack of captives. As for the guys in Britannia, I mean, the only way I can get captives is to attack the Scottish, but then they'll attack me, which is what I really don't want them to do, because I'm finally getting a good thing going here, trying to build this province up. They're going to rush in with their sacks, sack everything and leave, and I'll just cry and rage quit.
Yeah, they have so many, like, they have navies to surround you.
Yeah, they're some awkward positions.
And having Rotom Magus is annoying as well, although...
Yeah, that's a weird one.
Oh, shit, yeah. Okay, apparently one of the parts of Rotom Magus is actually desolate as well, so when I want to have that, I'm going to have to... Oh, man, that's a lot of... Oh, my God.
Gaul's gone.
Everything to myself is fucking... Oh, I hate that future.
London's basically the best place you can possibly take. The rest of it is just gone. Burdigala is okay, so you can take the two capitals, but the rest of it's gone.
I guess the good thing is there's not going to be any enemies to myself anymore to worry about.
Well, that's it. There's no one's going to be recruiting there.
Who's gone through here? Who was that did that?
It must have been the Jutes who were just rushing around. Or maybe it was the Caledonians, because they did have forces in central Gaul.
Such a grudge they hold.
Like, he was pretty cheeky of them.
God.
So, like, our home region's actually quite nice compared to the rest of the world in terms of destruction. Like, everywhere else is just going really downhill.
Yeah, if you go east with your camera as well, everything's... Here too.
Unassigned skill to deal with. AMR, who's he? He's the leader of my forces in the capital. Let's not give him some zeal. What does that do? Plus 4 integrity. Oh, that's good. So his integrity might be okay.
Oh my god, in the far east, there's literally nothing that's alive still.
Sorry, god.
Interrupting, but yeah.
It's fine to assign a governor. I'm going to assign this random guy. He's a master planner, so that sounds useful. He's the governor of my random eastern province. I can give them an edict. Can I give them something that stops them being so goddamn uppity? What's the one that gives you happiness? Plus 4 from German paganism. It's 99% German pagan. Yes, finally I use for that.
Yeah.
Joyous. Right, let's keep going. So the public order might improve there now. Steady on minus 72.
Steady.
Steady now, chaps. Stop rebelling now. Put those flaming torches down.
Oh, here we go again.
Danes. What are the Danes up to? What are the Geats up to? We know what the Geats are up to. It's nothing at all. It looks like they're up to something, but it's a net nothing. A zero-sum strategy from the Geats.
Up to no good. Started making trouble in my neighborhood.
That's it. It is my neighborhood as well.
Oh,
I actually
crap.
Want them to make more trouble.
I just encountered the Visigoths, by the way.
Ah, did you? What are they doing up here?
Yeah, I don't know. I
guess it was them who destroyed all of Eastern Europe. It was them and the Huns are just going around burning everything.
Maybe. Oh, crap. Here comes the Western Roman Empire.
What do they want?
They're
gonna fight the rebels. That's good of them.
Okay, come on.
Are they gonna do anything else?
Oh crap!
What's this? Oh. Another one?
Oh god, that's
they're just like running through your territory, like, just passing through.
Okay. They could have easily taken anything they wanted there.
They
were coming from the north a little bit, like.
Yeah, they were somewhere east of you, I think, and they just moved through to the west.
They don't own anything over there. That's all. Like,
I guess.
Tribes.
Yeah, they must have just been randomly fighting someone and got bored.
Oh, are they gonna take it?
Oh my god, they're going for it.
Oh, sweet. Oh my god, how do they recruit so many units in one go? Not that I care, but... Oh, they got mercenaries in there.
Oh yeah.
Smart.
Looked up.
Okay, sweet. If I was over it, I should lose it. But you
sweet!
You want to fight it just to make sure that I lose it?
Well, that could be an interesting battle.
Yeah, let's do it.
See how badly we can lose.
Yes.
They've got some onagers, so if we go and stand in a... strategic position, their laser guided onagers should be able to take us down.
Definitely, yeah. I don't actually have that much. Well, I mean, it's. I was gonna say I don't have that much time, but it's not like I'm gonna stop halfway through the battle. But we'll have to end it as the moment this ends.
Okay, this is gonna be the final moment in this battle, the glorious defeat. So, ladies and gentlemen, you're gonna be wondering why we lose this battle, and it's not because we're bad at playing the game, it's actually because we're good, because we're trying to lose. And so, by losing, we did what we wanted. And a good player is able to do what they want in the game. So this is going to be a sign of our skill.
Actually, I should do as much damage as possible because you'll be taking this soon. And you don't want to be facing off against the full army. So I guess I will try, but I'll still lose.
If you can like just pick a unit and try and totally destroy it just so it's not there. Because there's no point getting them down because they'll probably just regenerate their troops 100%.
Oh god, we're going to do so much damage with archer towers, by the way, if I just sit as far back as possible. Yeah, I'll try to win it.
We're
going to
win this battle.
Oh, crap.
God damn. Or maybe if they're very clever, they'll move up their onages and destroy the towers, but I don't know if they're going to be that clever.
Who knows? We'll have to find out. This is not one of those towns that has like a proper walled up place somewhere on top, it seems, where you would...
Yes, there's nowhere particularly convenient to defend.
No,
just
so
pick a point and say that's where we were going to hold.
It's in the middle then, I guess.
There's no capture point, is there? It's C1. Oh, there's one there, yeah. Okay, I guess we'll set on the capture point and see what happens.
Okay, I'll mount my units here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, naval reinforcements. Very nice. What are they? Germanic marauders. Yeah, they look alright, actually. Nice shiny helmets.
What are my ships anyway? They're light melee. Okay, yeah, because I don't really have any melee troops. So I'll give you this cav unit.
Oh, yeah.
Somewhere, I don't know where.
They mounted brigands. Light skirmish cav.
Light skirmish, yeah. Right, I can put down one barricade. Sadly, it only lets you put it where the game allows you. You can't really choose any good spots, because otherwise I put it like right... where are my drawing tools? I don't know, here. I'd put it on like one of the outer parts and I just camp it, but you can only put it on like two sides, which is kind of inconvenient. Actually, there's three. There's one like behind. What the fuck would I ever put it there? What am I going to defend there? It's ridiculous.
You just don't want to hold the town?
No, apparently. All right, I'll put it on the right here, so they can't really flank around. That's something. Also means you can't flank around them, but screw it.
We don't need tactics. We're trying to lose here.
That's true, yeah.
Let's just stand here and see if they react. I wonder if they are going to use their onagers to their advantage. So they're charging men in right away, so maybe they're not going to try and defeat the towers. Oh, they're firing. It's flaming shot. Oh no, they are firing at the tower.
Okay. Oh god.
They just totally missed.
Oh, they did
it. Oh wait, but they set it on fire.
Yeah, it's already on fire.
Yeah, it's sufficiently on fire now.
Oh god, that's pretty cool.
Oh, they're totally burning the capture point as well. Well, that's the end of that tower.
Yeah.
So I guess they are just going to wipe them out.
Is that tower going to do any damage before it quickly dies? Oh,
might be able to see a couple of shots off. This is very lucky. Oh no, they fired another volley at it.
Oh, it's still
firing.
But
they were missed as well, so it's still firing, yes.
It's killed a few men so far.
Nice one.
Keep going, Archer Tower. You're on 98%, and it's dead.
No. So they got a couple, did they? They got three men in that leading enemy unit, light melee troops. Oh, that pike squad is sprinting really fast.
One of them is going to trip over and jump on its spike.
Hopefully. Well, I guess the onagers might be out of range of the other tower, so that might get a bunch of kills as they come in. What else they got? They're doing okay. I'm wondering, I might try and use my skirmish cav to throw spears into the pikes, because they're so tightly packed. Might be able to get some nice kills.
Yeah, go for
it. But actually, all those other enemy cav are right in the same place. That's probably not going to work. Oh, they're starting to capture the tower. The tower must be getting loads of kills, though. It's shooting at them at point-blank range. Oh, it is. Those towers are so overpowered.
Yeah, they're so crazy good on damage. It's insane. Okay, here we go. Fire arrows into their axemen. Not doing anything.
Nice. They're coming in. Skirmish cav, you're on skirmish mode? You're not. Or whatever. Throw some jabs at him. Got a couple. Oh, they're skirmishing in an awkward direction. Okay, they've captured one of our towers.
Haven't killed a single man with the arrows yet.
Perfect.
That's what I like to see.
My skirmish cav, I think they're being... Oh, some of them are stuck. Yeah, they're getting killed because they're stuck behind the enemy's lines. Right. Don't skirmish. Oh, we defeated one of their cav units.
Awesome.
Battle is no longer in our favor, apparently.
Apparently it was in our favor at some point.
Oh, the enemies. Yeah, the enemies like cav.
Still not a single kill for our infantry or our archers. Let's do some heavy shots.
We'll show. Okay, the cavalry are going. That's the end of them. A couple of kills among the enemy's Nordic axe.
Oh, we got another archer tower shooting in there now.
Nice.
Nice, mate. Oh, they're flanking around with some pikes now.
Yeah, they've caught my skirmish cav. That's the end of them. Our men are wavering. Yeah, that pike's coming for the flank attack. They're using their skirmish cav quite well. Losing a lot of men in the Germanic and Marauders.
Oh god. The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
The men are broken. Well, that's my skirmish cav going. Yeah, that's the end of them. Come on, we can still lose this. Enemy's pikes are glitching out.
That's what I like to see.
Oh, here they come. They formed up. They're coming in.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. That action has completely wrecked my spear line, apparently.
Nice. The enemy have some sort of female unit there. What's it called? The Baugadai.
Yeah, I can recruit those as well. They're absolutely horrible.
Excellent.
Where is that one? I want to see it.
Right, the archers are getting quite piked.
Yeah.
And axed, by the looks of it.
They got one unit.
Oh, that guy, I actually just saw someone was doing actual axe animations. See, I thought the axes used sword animations. It looks like they do have unique ones now. That looks good.
Oh, what a shame, eh? We lost that.
Decisive defeat. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We just didn't have the skill because we haven't fought enough battles.
Oh, we did kill the one cav unit. That's something, I guess.
So we wiped out one unit and depleted a couple of others a little bit.
Those arrows were just completely pointless. I just don't
see
the
point. You have 4 kills with an archery unit in a defensive battle, holding a settlement.
They fired like 5 or 6 times. Maybe more
very
than that. And they just, they're so useless. I hate archers in this game.
Yeah.
The javelins are so strong in comparison. I mean, they run out a lot faster, sure, but...
Like with javelins, you can get a couple hundred kills like in a minute.
Yeah,
with
exactly.
You'll get a couple of hundred kills over 20 minutes if they don't get engaged by anything else during
exactly,
that time.
Exactly. Yeah.
They'll very gradually kill them.
And then, like, once they run out of their javs, they can still you can still use them as a flanking unit or something.
Yeah, because they do the same morale shock as anyone else to attack at the rear, so they're fine for that. So the Frankish separatists are going to successfully separate.
What? That cavalry unit that survived with five men.
For God's sake.
That's ridiculous. They didn't take it?
Oh, come on. They did take it.
Take my town,
the
please.
The dream.
After all that.
Like, you think a separatist movement would be all about trying to suddenly gain territory. But all they did was, we're going to form a separatist nation. We're just going to burn everything and then sit in a tent. That's our separatist nation. Why would you join that?
Oh, that's really tough, though, because now I need to... I could just, like, let it rebel again, I suppose, if that's even possible.
Well, maybe they'll attack it again and decide they're not going to sack it. But I don't know. I guess the AI is a bit too sack-friendly, even in cases where it doesn't make sense for them to do it. The East Germanic separatists trespassing in my territory there, and they're raiding it. That's not very kind of them. But anyway, we'll have to deal with them next time. This is the end of the episode.
It is indeed.
Yes, nay.
Just quickly going over these things. Trade gained. Oh, another procrastinator one. Great.
Yep.
That's what I like to see. Get a bunch of units. And a rank gain for Jaina Bard. Great. Good for him. Right. They're actually replenishing men as well, even though they're just standing there, and they're raiding the town. So yeah, that's kind of annoying. So I don't know, maybe we'll have to wait and see if they attack again. The thing is, if they go for Colonia Agrippa, although I guess I can move my army over there, so should be able to deal with that next time, hopefully.
It's so difficult to loot your own provinces in this game.
It really is.
So difficult to take enemy provinces. It's difficult to do anything.
It really is. All right, anyway, so thank you guys all for watching. I hope you enjoyed once again, and we shall see you next time.
See you next time, everyone.
Bye.